Hey guys, this is Abhishek from GadgetsToDoodles.com, and today we are going to do the quick unboxing and quick review of the Micromax Canvas Doodle 4. So Micromax Canvas Doodle 4 has been recently launched in India for a very affordable price of approximately 9,500 rupees, for which you can buy this 6-inch display phone. And one of the good thing about Micromax is that they always plan to launch this series of phone and make it very affordable, especially for those who would like to buy an affordable Android phone which comes with as big display as the premium ones actually get. For example, you can compare the display size of this device at least with the Google Nexus 6, which comes for approximately 50,000 rupees, whereas this one is less than 10,000 rupees and you're getting the same display size as far as the screen is concerned. So let's take a look what we have inside the packaging. I have already used this phone for approximately 2 days. So before doing this review, I have tested certain things with the phone and I'm going to tell you all that, including the good things as well as the not so good things of this phone. I will highlight them all in this video. Let's take a look what we have inside the packaging. We already know that the phone is outside, so let me see what else is there inside. And this is how the box looks like. We have the Canvas Doodle 4, which is the name of the phone mentioned over there, Micromax branding over there, and on this side as well we have the phone name mentioned. On this side we have some other sticker which are related to manufacturing. Over there at the back side we have specifications for the device mentioned, which includes a MediaTek 6582M quad core 1.3 GHz CPU. It is a Cortex A7 processor, and we have Corning Gorilla Glass 3 as well on this device, which is definitely a good thing. And we have QHD display, which is 960 into 540, which you can see over there, and it is a 6-inch display. The internal storage is 8 GB and RAM is 1 GB DDR3. We have 8-megapixel rear camera, which is an autofocus camera, and we have 2-megapixel fixed focus front camera. We have Android Lollipop 5.0 on this device, which is definitely good. We have battery which is 3000 milliampere, and this battery is actually non-removable battery, so you cannot remove the battery. However, you can actually remove the back cover. And then we have the frequencies mentioned for 3G. So it does support 3G, but it does not support 4G. And you do have support for full high definition video recording from the rear camera, which is 8 megapixel, and you can also play high definition video on this device. And then we have some information about the applications which are coming pre-installed, which includes Evernote Sketch and Evernote application as well. And then they have also mentioned that this phone actually has Corning Gorilla Glass 3. So let me just open the packaging and show you what we have inside. So here we have the packaging open. The phone is already out, so let me just take a look over this box, which looks like a big box actually. And just get it out and show you what we have inside this one. So opening it from this side reveals nothing, but let me just open it from this side and show you what we have inside. Okay, I think we have to take things out in a different way. Yeah, so over here we have the charger and the micro USB cable, and there are some headphones as well which are there inside the packaging. Yeah, so over here we have these headphones which are coming inside the packaging. These are again standard headphones which you are getting. Nothing too great about them in terms of the quality. We have a mic module over there with a button to pick the call, and this is how the audio lead look like. The headphones are again standard, nothing special. We have the micro USB cable which can be used for data syncing and charging. And let me just get the charger out as well so that I can show you the output current. And the output current from this charger is, it is a 1.5 ampere charger, better than the normal regular 1 ampere charger. So it will charge your device slightly faster, but it is not the fast charger, I would say, because fast charger normally come with 2 ampere of current. This is 1.5 ampere of current, which is definitely good, and it can charge your Canvas Doodle 4 in approximately 2 to 3 hours. You also get a flip cover within the package, so this is something very nice on the Micromax part. There is a flip cover which is coming inside the packaging. It has the same finishing as you see on the back cover of this phone. which can be removed, but the battery cannot come out. And then you have a separate window over there so that you can access notification and do different things on the phone without opening the flip part of the flip cover. And then we have a screen guard which is coming pre-installed. You have a user guide over there, a pamphlet over there for downloading, and then you have a pamphlet which tells you about the MAD application, how you can actually watch ads and earn from them. This will be useful for people who would like to have a free recharge of their prepaid connection. And then we have the SAR values which are mentioned over there, which is 0.20 watt per kg and 0.57 watt per kg over there for head and body. And then we have the warranty card as well. And these are all things which you get within the package. So the unboxing is over now. Let me just get rid of the packaging and we will take a deeper look over the Micromax Canvas Doodle 4 which we have with us over there. So here we have the Micromax Canvas Doodle 4, which is definitely a bigger device when you hold it in hand, and it also feels slightly heavy. It is around 158 gram, which is again not too much as far as the weight of a 6-inch device is concerned. So it is not very heavy considering this is a 6-inch display phone. They have optimized the weight to a great extent and they have given it a very nice curvy back over there, which will give you a very nice grip when you hold this phone in hand. And it has a matte finish back cover which is very smooth, so it gives you very good grip and a very good feel. We have an 8 megapixel camera over there, autofocus camera it is, a dual LED flash, Micromax branding over there. On this side we have the power and flip key and the volume locker. Both of these buttons are decent. Again, they are not metallic buttons, but the power and flip key actually does not give too much of feedback, but decent enough I would say. The volume locker actually gives better feedback. On the top you have a 3.5 audio jack over there, and secondary microphone is something which we cannot locate on this one. Probably it may not have it. We have the primary microphone over there at the bottom, a micro USB port for data syncing and charging, and here we have a little indent to remove the back cover. Let me just remove the back cover. So once you remove the back cover, you can see that the battery is not removable, and it is a 3000 milliampere battery which can give you around 1 day battery backup on this phone pretty easily. We have two SIM card slots over there in which you can insert a micro SIM, and we do have a micro SD card slot as well on this side so that you can expand the storage and you can also install applications on the micro SD memory card. As far as edges are concerned, the edges are again made up of plastic, not metal, but they have given it a look just like metal, so it looks premium. And again, on the build quality front, the phone is not bad at all. They have given a very good build quality on the phone. It feels solid in your hand and the look and feel is quite impressive, especially the white version which we have with us. We have touch capacitive buttons which are there within the body of the phone. They are not within the display, but they do not have any backlit LED, which is kind of a compromise they have done. Over here we have the nice metallic earpiece, proximity and ambient light sensors, and we have a front camera as well. And the front camera on this one is a 2 megapixel fixed focus camera. Let's take a look over the UI. The UI is again pretty responsive. I do not see any issues with this one, and the phone is responsive most of the time. There is a slight flutter in the UI, but the overall UI is pretty responsive. Let me just get rid of this. So this is how the phone dialer look like. The phone dialer is again basic one, and you can easily dial the number, but you cannot make a filter video call. Let's take a look over the messaging application, and this is how it looks like. If I compose a new message, this is how the keyboard look like. The keyboard is again stock Android, as what you see in Lollipop. So swipe to type is again supported, and whenever you tap on any of these keys, you do get a pop-up of whatever key you are pressing. Typing on this device is a pretty good experience. I did not face any kind of issues. Anyone with thick or thin fingers can actually type on this one. And in the landscape mode as well, it gives you a lot of room to type in case you would like to do that. Let's take a look over some of the things. Let's first of all go into notification center. This is how it looks like. Let me just go into settings and find out the version of Android. First of all, the exact version of Android on this one is 5.0. Let me just come back and take a look over the storage now. And on the storage front, we have got 8 GB of internal storage. Out of that, 4.87 GB is available, and we have installed certain applications, and there are certain applications, or I would say a lot of bloatware applications, which are coming pre-installed, and you can always get rid of them. These are the applications which are taking approximately 1.58 GB on the phone. You can actually reclaim the space and get around 4.87 GB available on this device. We do have support for SD card, and OTG is also supported, and you can insert an OTG flash drive in case you would like to do that. OTG is definitely supported. Let's take a look over the application scenario. On the application scenario front, we have approximately 1 GB of RAM on this phone, and out of that, 557 MB of RAM is free, and the device is fairly responsive and it is running smoothly. I did not face any major issues. Again, whenever you boot up the phone, you will see more applications which are coming pre-installed, or either they are getting updated automatically once you are connected to the Wi-Fi. So in case you don't want them, you can always uninstall them as well. Let's take a look over some more internal configuration settings. We do have support for location access as well. You can actually use GPS navigation, and when it comes to sharing internet options, you do have that as well supported. Tethering is supported. You can either create a portable Wi-Fi hotspot, or you can also do USB tethering, and Bluetooth tethering is also supported. Let me just come out of this menu, and we will talk about some more things, which includes the magic gestures. So magic gestures are there supported on this one, and I can show you what all that is there, especially as far as these features are concerned. So we have a gesture switch, we have a gesture controller, and other things as well. You can actually draw a O to open up the clock, you can draw a C to open up the camera, and I think we can do that by turning off the display. So if I draw a C, it will open up the camera. Yeah, yes, it does take time, but these features does work. And similarly, you can do a lot of nifty things on this one. Let me just come back and go into the settings again to show you some more things. So we have different kind of gestures which are supported, which includes the clock gesture, camera gesture, and other things as well. Now here we have the camera UI. Let me just take a photo from the rear camera on this one, and I will take this photo again without the artificial light. I have to disable the flash first of all. Yeah. So I've just taken both of these photos, and it does take some time to capture the photo, especially in case you are in a low light scenario. The photo which we have taken with light has came out to be good in terms of details, in terms of clarity. Everything is looking nice, especially this is the one which has been taken with light, and it is looking nice in terms of clarity and details. And the other one which we have taken without light, this one is again decent, I would say, in terms of clarity and details. The colors are also nicely reproduced. Let's take a look over the front camera. Again, the rear camera is good, but not great. Unless you hold this device stable, you will not get very good photos. And let me just take a front camera selfie as of now. So it does take some time to capture these photos. Let me just take this photo one more time. So it is definitely not very fast as far as camera shutter is concerned. This is how these selfies look like. This one has been taken with light. Again, this one is looking good, but the moment you zoom in, you will see a lot of noise. Things are not very clear, but for a 2 megapixel camera, it is doing a decent job, and this is how the other selfie look like. Both of these selfie photos are looking good, especially when we have captured them in low light. I would say the front camera is doing a decent job. Again, when it comes to high definition video recording, you can record high definition video from the rear camera, but you cannot do the same from the front camera. And the camera UI is very simple and basic, so there is nothing complex to understand it. You do have panorama mode as well, and HDR mode is also supported on this one. Let's take a look over some more things, which includes the video playback capability. So first of all, we will play a video on this device and find out the overall experience when it comes to display. The display on this one is again an IPS TFT display, which is good, I would say, in terms of viewing angles, but not great. Let me just show you the clarity of the video. we will play a high definition video, and we will also find out whether that gets played in high definition clarity or at some other resolution. We will find that out. Let me search for that. So here we have the video. And again, this device, in terms of connectivity, I do not see any major problem. Everything is responsive and smooth. So here we have the video playing, and the video is getting played nicely. The viewing angles are good, if not great. I can see the video and the display of the device from extreme angles. There is slight amount of color fading which is happening, but the display is visible, which is nice. When it comes to the resolution at which it is getting played, let me just find that out. So it is getting played at 480p. However, you can actually play high definition videos as well on this phone. Let me just increase the volume to full. So volume is full right now, and I can hear this device pretty loud and clear. So in terms of the overall volume of sound which comes out from the loudspeaker at the backside, it is pretty loud. And even if you place it like this on a table, the sound does not get blocked completely, but it does get muffled a bit. Now here we have the hardware information for the phone. The model number of the device is Micromax Q391, and we have ARMv7 processor clocked at 1.3 GHz. It is a MediaTek 6582M processor, and we have display resolution which is 514x960. We have Mali 400MP GPU on this phone, and here we have the sensors, which includes the accelerometer sensor, proximity sensor, light gyroscope and gravity sensor. Magnetic field sensor is missing on this device, but GPS navigation works on this one. However, it will take some time to log the GPS coordinates, and you need to be outdoor. Especially indoor, it might be a problem for this phone to actually log the GPS coordinates and do GPS navigation. In terms of battery backup, you can expect around 1 day of battery backup pretty easily on this device, considering the kind of display resolution it has and the kind of overall UI it has. Again, we have got more than 1 day of battery backup on this phone, and the phone in terms of heating does not heat up that much, but it will get slightly warm over there, especially when you do gaming, and it may be slightly hot, but not that uncomfortable that you cannot hold it while using it. So that's all from us. Do let us know if you have any specific question for this device. We would love to help you. We give a thumbs up to the Canvas Doodle 4, which comes with a decent build quality, a pretty good display size, and a very nice responsive UI, which is responsive and smooth enough in day-to-day usage most of the time. So that's all from us. Do let us know if you have any specific question for this phone. We would love to help you. You can like the video, this video help you, by clicking the like button below. In case you have any questions, you can leave your questions in the comment section below. You can also subscribe to our YouTube video channel for more videos like this by clicking the subscribe button below. Thanks for watching this video. This is Abhishek signing off. This is Canvas Doodle quick hands-on review and unboxing for you. This is Abhishek signing off. Thank you.